And going from 3.5 Bitcoin a day to 11, 11.5 Bitcoin in the next 6 to 9 months is really quite significant. I think it'll all happen within 6 months, but I always, you never know with all this tariff war that disruptions the supply lines, but we've seen things showing up.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Frank Holmes. He is the executive chairman of Hive Digital Technologies. And Frank, welcome back. Good to see you again.
It's great to be with you.
Yeah, so the company out with news today talking about your operations in Paraguay and continued that of all the work that you're doing there, you've hit some critical milestones, Frank.
Yes, and it's trying to demonstrate to the public that we're on this path of scaling and scaling from 6.5 exahash to 25 by year end. And we expect this 10% increase month over month is quite significant. And we're expecting this to happen again in the next month. And so that's why I think this articulating the rapid expansion.
Yeah, you really have. You've gone, as you mentioned, you've got a 10% increase over last month's hash rate. And then, and you, as you said, you're going to continue doing that. But for people that know the space that you're in, 10% in 1 month seems to be a pretty big one to jump.
Yes, but and going from 3.5 Bitcoin a day to 11.5 Bitcoin in the next 6 to 9 months is really quite significant. I think it'll all happen within 6 months, but I always, you never know with all this tariff war that disruptions the supply lines, but we've seen things showing up. We've been flying in, as we showed one of the photographs of all the security we have, because those trucks have millions of dollars of these valuable chips. So we can't afford any risk. It's like moving a ton of gold.
Mm-hmm. Usage that you have is important. Is it just the increase in the type of machines that you're using there, Frank, and also the added megawatts that you have? Is that sort of the secret sauce to the increase?
Well, it was the strategic acquisition. The acquisition of Bitfarms Paraguayan assets fast-tracked our growth profile and allowed us to really scale. And then we'd already purchased the equipment for the 100 megawatts last year. So we had equipment coming, and we've been able to finance our internally. And in addition to that, we've been able to redeploy 30 megawatts of our buzz miners. Well, that was the first real Intel chip that we did with Intel and partnering, creating an ASIC chip in North America. We've been able to get our money back in Canada and Sweden, and then redeploy those in Paraguay where the cost of electricity is less.
Hey, Frank, thought it'd be a great update to talk about Valenzuela. I know construction is advancing there. I say Valenzuela, not Venezuela.
Yes, well, in Valenzuela, not Venezuela. It's a very tricky tongue there. You have to be so careful of. We in Paraguay, it's not far from the capital city. It is all on track. There was a big ceremony about the growth of, after the substation was built. So I'm very excited about these developments for a multitude of reasons. But for Hive in particular, we will grow. If you take a look at Bitcoin at $100,000, and if you're doing 11 Bitcoin a day, that's $1.1 million a day in revenue. So that's quite significant. And I think that Bitcoin trades higher, and I think our production can increase in addition. That's very positive for the company.
Absolutely. Frank, thanks so much for the update. Really good to get an update on where you're at and obviously where you're going, which is being aggressive and moving up. So thanks a lot.
Well, it's great to be able to share hash rate milestones, we like to call them. And so hopefully next time it'll be 8 exahash.
All right. We look forward to that. Frank Holmes, the executive chairman of Hive Digital Technologies.